back at a moment in Queensland's history.
This was how the South Bank looked in June 1985. The Clem Jones Park along the river. And behind that, a jumbled collection of rundown warehouses, battling businesses and temporary car parks. The once proud suburb had descended to this. But the seeds of South Bank's salvation had been sown back in 1973 by a bloke called Gough Whitlam.
The government finally decided to acquire the area we now know as South Bank. It was a tough decision, and one not always popular with a public who hadn't yet quite grasped the vision of Expo 88.
But the two alternative sites were simply too far from the city, and here was an opportunity of a lifetime. By October 1985, with the exception of one or two buildings and those that were to be kept, the site had been cleared, driving home the immensity of the task that had been undertaken. For the first time since 1842, the land that was home to those early lean-tos and shanties was clear again.